Life Fellowship Church.
Morning.
Some of y'all are still a little groggy. That's what I was trying to say, not growly. Maybe some of you are that too. Stand on your feet and let's go to God and worship. Good morning. How are you? How many is glad to be in the house of the Lord on this Sunday morning? Got to sleep in an extra hour. Everybody should be as perky as all get up. Look at your neighbor and tell them, I have come to worship my Lord. Amen, because he is worthy. Lord, you are holy. Thank you. King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Holy is his name. Amen. Hallelujah. He is good all the time and all the time. My God is good. He's never failed me once. He's never abandoned me once. Amen. He has always been there right beside me, hand in hand through every struggle, every trial, every mountain, every valley. God is always there. Amen. And he is always good. Hallelujah. Lift him up one more time and give him praise this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We praise you, Lord. We praise you, Lord. We praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Well, it is good to be at LFC this morning. Do you feel that way? Hallelujah. I feel the presence of the Spirit already engulfing this place. And I believe that God is going to do a work in your life this morning. He's going to do a work in my life this morning. How many needs him? I know I do. Every day, every minute, every second. Hallelujah. Well, we are glad that you have come to join us this morning. And we want to make you feel welcome. And we want to cross the aisles and the boundaries of that little thing right there and step across them. Grab somebody up. Hug them. Tell them how glad you are to see them at church this morning. Amen. Find somebody that you've never seen before here and tell them how glad you are to see them at LFC. We praise you, God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Ready? All right. Let's go, guys. Praise to him right now. Let's just take out time for him. God, we thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We honor you today, Lord. Holy are you, God. Holy are you, God, that you bless us, Father. You bless us, God, with grace and favor and increase and healing, God, and prosperity, Father. We thank you that you are faithful. We thank you that you are faithful, Father. We praise you, we praise you, we praise you, we praise you, we praise you. God, we thank you, Father. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Come on, just lift your hands and tell him, God, I'm here. I need you, Father. Do in my life what you want to be done, God. Cleanse me. Purify me, Father. Make my heart new. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you, God. How many know he has unending, unmerited favor? We praise you, Jesus. We're speechless in your sight this morning, God. We praise you, Father. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Unending, but always on.
Undeserving. Let's give him praise this morning. Hallelujah. He's truly worthy. Oh, all of us come to him on the same level. We all need his grace. No matter what walk of life, no matter what we've went through, no matter who we are, we all need the grace of God. I'm so thankful for his grace this morning. Let's give him praise. Lord, I thank you for your grace. I thank you for your goodness. I thank you for your mercies, which are new every morning, your compassions, which never fail to the children of men. We give you praise this morning. Hallelujah. It's wonderful to see Sister Dorothy Houston here this morning. Amen. We know it's been the prayers of the saints and that has brought her forward. And we were singing from generation to generation. And I was thinking when she walked in, she's a generation and they're a generation. Hallelujah. The presence of God has worked through their lives. And it's so wonderful to see Dorothy this morning. And the prayers of the saints are answered by God. And you know, there's people here this morning that want to pray with you. No matter what you're going through, no matter what you're facing, God is here to meet your need. No matter seemingly how insignificant or how great it might seem to you, God is able to meet your need this morning. So if our prayer warriors would come at this time and be ready for those that need prayer this morning, I want to encourage you, don't hold back. So much is accomplished in this area up here around the altar. You know, it's a sacred place. It's a place where we come to meet God. Amen. It's a place where we come to surrender to him. It's a place where we come and allow him to move in our lives. So if you have a need this morning, I want you to find one of these to meet with and pray. Whatever that need might be, no matter how great or small, God's able. Would you come at this time as we continue to worship the Lord?
Yeah. mountains shake before you, the demons run and flee. At the mention of your name, King of Majesty, there is no power in hell or any who can stand before the power and the presence of the great I am.
Presence of the Lord is here this morning. Amen. It's good to be in the house of the Lord. The Lord wants you to know that He is with you. He is for you, not against you. Whatever you face, greater is He that is in you than he that is in the world. And you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. He'll be with you. You know, when we were praying this morning, the thought came to me, a lot of people think about spiritual needs, but God's concerned about every single need you face. Whether it be a family situation, whether it be a financial situation, a job situation, God's able to meet that need because He supersedes everything. Hallelujah. And I know that God is going to be at work in every situation that we commit to Him. He's able to keep what we've committed, amen, to Him. He's able to do far beyond what we ask or imagine this morning. So whatever need you have, God is faithful. God is faithful. God is faithful to meet that need. I am so thankful. Let's give Him praise this morning. Hallelujah. We give You praise, Lord, for Your faithfulness. You are the great I Am. You are the becoming one. Whatever's needed, You are the bread of life. You are the Jehovah Jireh. You are our shepherd. Lord, You're our banner. Hallelujah. Whatever's needed, You're there for us, and we give You the praise. We give You the glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Would you greet those around you this morning and let them know you're good, glad to see them in the house of the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Well, let's just give the Lord another hand of praise. Hallelujah. He's worthy. You know, the Dallas Cowboys are on a winning streak right now, and people are kind of crazy. I've seen more navy blue going around in stars on trucks and people wearing it. Boy, they were ashamed of it there for a couple of years, packing the back of the closet, but now they're bringing it out and really supporting them. But I tell you what, the Lord is worthy. He's greater than any football team, any financial team, whatever you might come up with, medical team, God is greater. Amen. He deserves the glory this morning. Hallelujah. Well, as we said earlier, it's so good to see Sister Dorothy Houston back with us this morning, and we're glad you're in the house of the Lord. Mamaw Hooper got to go home this week, and Miss Audrey, Marla's mom, came home from surgery. Miss Diane Clark has went home. So we praise God for all those that had that long extended stay. God's been at work. Amen. Want to give you a few announcements. Sister Doris Davis is starting a encounter class in room 104 on Sunday mornings. It started this morning, and it's discovering God through His Word, and we want to invite you to be a part of that. Also, we do have the upper room prayer going on also in room 101 at the same time, and so whichever you can come and join and be a part of, you will be blessed and strengthened. Amen? And we want to remember that our nursing home is today at 2 o'clock, and those of you that can come, we put 1:45 in the bulletin for those of you that need a little extra umph. Some of you work on a different time clock than others. But it does start right at 2, and Brother Rufus will be ministering the word. And we have a wonderful time. Sister Angie plays the piano. We have a wonderful time. The residents there are blessed, and we worship God. Come and join us if you can. Also, this Tuesday, our first meeting for men in the morning will be at, there we go, 6 a.m. the 4th at McDonald's over here on Sublet. And you men that, before you go to work, that can get together in the mornings. Some of them I talked to this morning said they don't get up that early. They'll go to the evening one this month. But some of y'all get up with the chickens. Y'all have a different time clock. And so that will be available there Tuesday morning. And Brother Keith Willis will have a time of devotion and encouragement. So y'all come and join that for about 30 minutes. Also want to remind you that next Sunday, our singles are getting together, singles Sunday, and we're going to meet on the 8th, and we'll be going to Pam's house and bringing finger foods or potluck, if you call it, want to call it that. And the information is in the bulletin, those of you that are interested in that. Our men's breakfast is coming up this month as well. It'll be on the 15th at 8 a.m., and we have a wonderful time with pancakes and bacon and sausage and scrambled. Do I need to stop? Some of us didn't get breakfast. Those of you that are interested in joining our church, you're already a part of it and you come here regularly, but you want to know more about our church, we're having a Life Connection class on November 22nd from 10 to 12. And what we do during that time for those couple hours, we provide you some breakfast, and we also tell you about the different departments of our church and how we function here at Life Fellowship Church. Pastor Danny leads that. And Let's just be sure to say a prayer for him this morning. He is very much under the weather, and we want God to touch him and bless him. Amen. Let's just do that right now. Father, we thank you for our pastor. We ask, Father, your hand be upon him, that you touch him and minister to him in his body. In Jesus' name, we give you the praise. Amen. Well, if our ushers will come at this time, we want to take our offering. And I want to tell you, last Cowboy Day, last Sunday, was awesome, wasn't it? Amen. We had a wonderful time around here. And I tell you, that was the best burger I have eaten in years. Brother Gary and Brother Jerry just knew what they were doing over there on the grill. And we had a wonderful time. Also, thank every one of you for your support in the various ways that you helped us. And it was a wonderful success. Friday night, we had Trunk or Treat. And I guarantee you there was over 200 kids, probably, maybe close to 300. We had 15 cars. It was wonderful. And we appreciate all of you that participated. The guy next to me in truck number two. I've tried to bribe kids with candy. I gave them three or four pieces, four or five, especially towards the end. You start loading them up. Remember number one? No. I even had Charles' son come over and ask me, what's his number? I wanted to say, number one. No, he was number two. Alton and Stephanie won first place by a landslide with their car, with Hawaiian Luau. And Denisa and Jeremy and Brandy, I got to give them kudos. They won second place, and they gave me a couple of slices of pizza. I stayed alive while we was out there. Praise God. We give them, thank each and every one of you for coming. We had a wonderful time. We had a Pac-Man car, Mickey Mouse car, all kinds of cars. It was wonderful. Thank you for your support and turning out. It was a wonderful deal. Ushers, if you would come at this time, thank you for your faithfulness in giving. We're able to do what we need to do and accomplish for the kingdom of God because of your faithfulness. And God, in turn, blesses you in your life. Amen. He said in Malachi, if you'll just try me, I will open the windows of heaven over your life, and I will pour out upon you a blessing that you cannot contain. And I can testify that as I put God first, everything else falls in place. Amen. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for your faithfulness to us. We thank you, Lord, for your blessings upon each and every one of us. I ask your blessing be upon each individual and each household and each business that's represented as we give of our first fruits to you, as you have blessed us, Lord, and of our offerings and our love offerings to you, Lord. We thank you for your faithfulness to us. In Jesus' name, amen. The ladies are coming to sing a beautiful song for us this morning.
Amen. Sister Renee asked us that we sing this song before she preaches this morning. And it's a great song. It's an anointed song because it talks about the name of Jesus and how that he is wonderful and glorious and omnipotent. God the Father. Amen. Hallelujah.
Lord, you're holy. You're holy, and we lift you up and magnify your name.
Can you do that with us this morning?
Lord, you're holy. Lord, you're holy, and we lift you up and magnify your name.
And I see all the works your hands have made, the awesomeness of you, and how your love will never fade. Mere words cannot express what I feel inside. I can't describe your glory divine, but as a token of my love, this is what I'll do. I'll lift my hands and cry, holy,
you're holy.
Lord, you're holy.
Lord, you're holy.
All the wonderful things you've given me. Oh, your love and kindness, your tender mercy.
I
want to praise you, Lord.
And tell you how much I love you
because you're worthy of all the glory. Lord, you're worthy of all my praise.
This morning. Hallelujah. Oh, glory, glory, glory. Let's give him praise in this house. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Girls, don't go too far. I think we need to sing that again. He deserves the glory. He deserves the praise this morning. He's worthy. Hallelujah.
To worship him. It is not hard to bow down at his feet. It's not hard to lift your hands and giving praise and honor that is due his name. I know him as healer. I know him as deliverer. I know him as my shield and my buckler and my high tower. Oh, come on. If you know him, lift him up and give him praise.
Lord,
yes, God, we worship you, Lord.
And we lift you up and magnify your name.
Oh,
Lord,
Wonderful, glorious. Come on, church, let's stand to your feet this morning. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Blessed be his name. Blessed be his name. Keith, can you come up here for a minute? Oh, thank you, Jesus. 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 Beautiful. Beautiful. Hallelujah. Church, the presence of the Lord is here. The presence of the Lord is here. The power of his healing is here. The power of deliverance is here to set you free, to give you strength, to give you power to walk away from that thing that has been plaguing you, to give you the strength to do what you can't do in your own power. But by his power and through his might, you can do all things. Hallelujah. I feel the presence of the Lord is here. His healing is here. His healing is here. I know that under the sound of my voice, there are people that need healing in your body. And as Nathan was saying this morning, God cares even about the most minute issue. If you're having issues in your back, if you're having issues in your body, in your heart, in your hearing, in your sight, I believe the manifestation of the miracle working power and healing hand is being made known this morning to his children. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, church. I want you to lift your hand, every single one of you. Put it up to heaven right now. Put it up to heaven right now. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I want you to say it with your lips. Say, I receive all that you have for me according to your riches in glory. I receive your healing. I receive your strength. I receive your deliverance. I receive your power. I receive your might. I receive salvation for my family. Come on. Hallelujah. Come on. Receive it this morning. Receive it this morning. Receive it this morning. Receive it this morning. Hallelujah. 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 How many of you would say, I'm a needy people? And just like the song said, where would I be without your grace? Where would I be without your grace? I look around and I see people who have been healed, touched, delivered, saved, and dug, brought out of a pit. And you are standing successfully today because of all that God has done for you. And some of you might be dead. Some of you might not be functioning. Some of you might be poor and in poverty. But because of God, you are standing. You are victorious. You are provided for. The favor of the Lord is resting upon you today. And it's all because of our wonderful, glorious, holy, and righteous, victorious, triumphant, and mighty healer, deliverer, shield, and defense, strong tower, and my best friend, my omnipresent, omniscient, soon coming king, the Alpha, Omega, Lord of everything. Holy, 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 holy is your name. Holy is your name. Holy is your name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Michael, if you can at the back, I want you to bring the house lights down. I feel it. I feel it. It's time right this minute, right now. I want you to move. I want you to move out of your seat. And we're going to come before the altar because his spirit is here. And we're going to do this privately, but we're going to do this corporately. We're going to do it corporately. I want you to come before the altar of the Lord. Come on, somebody is going to walk out here different than when you came in. Somebody is walking out and you're never going to be the same. You're never. going to be the same. Come on. I want you to give it to God today. Give it to God today. Give it to God today. Today is your day. Today is your day. Today is your day for a miracle. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, here before your altar, I am unafraid. Come on.
Of every motive, every burden, everything that's of myself.
Come on, give it to him.
And I just want to wait on you, my God.
Oh, yes.
I just want to dwell on who.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Who you are. Beautiful. Beautiful. Oh, I am lost for more to say. Beautiful.
Oh, yes.
Beautiful. Oh, Lord. You're beautiful.
Oh yeah, that's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. Yes. Come on, that's it. He's moving on you, sister. He's moving on you. Come on, sing it.
Holy, you
sing it again. Holy, holy.
You are holy.
Yes. Sing it.
Holy, holy. Not like you, Lord. Holy, you are.
Sing it.
Holy,
yes.
You are, you are. Holy, holy, holy. You are, you are. Holy, holy, holy.
Sing it again. Worship you now. now with your voice. I just want you to worship him in your heavenly language, in English, however you decide. Again, in a spirit of reverence, I want you to show me your hand. If you think that God still heals, when God's people come together in unity in this atmosphere of worship, you have made an invitation for the Holy Spirit to come and do all that He is able to do. Because we always say not only God can, but He what? He will. He will. Say, He will. He will. He will. He is. He is. Right now. In Jesus' name. Now, I want somebody, and you guys can be seated. You can go or not be seated. I want you, hold on, I want you to do something in the physical to confirm what's happening in the spiritual and what's going on in your physical body. You know, I want you to take a step of faith. I want you to take a step of faith. I'm not asking you to do anything crazy. You don't have to leap over a building. It's a bird, it's a plane. But I want you to do something right now. I want you to do something. I want you to put feet on your faith. Faith without works is dead. I see a people, you know, God is here to heal, to deliver, to set free, to save. But I want you, I don't care if your need is financial, if your need is physical, like in your body, if your need is salvation, you need salvation for your family. I want you to do something. I want you to do something. I want you to stomp your foot. I want you to jump. I want you to take a little walk, a little jog. I want you to do a little jig. That's it. That's it. Come on. I want you to manifest in the physical. Come on now. Let's not play. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. We don't want to play today. We're not going to play. Come on now. I want you to get out of your comfort zone. Get out of your comfort zone today. Oh, that's it. Yeah, you do yourself a little spin. Oh, that's it. Come on. Come on now. I want you to step out of your seat, and I want you to do something right now. Do something. Anything. Do something. That's it. That's it. That's it. Come on. Let's do something. Let's do something. Come on. Come on. Let's do something. Do something. Yes. That's it. That's it. That's it. Hallelujah. That's it. Come on. That's it. Hey, I'm going patty cake with you, my friend. Let's patty cake. We're going to patty cake. Patty cake, patty cake. Baker's man. God, you can do it and nobody else can. In Jesus' name, patty cake, baker's man. Nobody can do it but Jesus can. Hallelujah. 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 That's it. That's it. Yes. 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 Yeah, that's it, sister. Come on now. Move it. Move it. Move it. That's it. That's it. Hallelujah. 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 Come on now. Come on now. Blessed be his name. Blessed be his name. Oh, that's it. Ooh, ooh. I feel the devil is leaving. I feel the devil is going. Ooh, we're scaring him right now. I feel it in my prayer. Oh, come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. That's it. I feel 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 it. Hallelujah. Oh, somebody. Oh, somebody. Ooh, come on now. Come on now. Come on. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, just lift your hands. We're just going to stick with this. We're going to stick with it. Hallelujah. Blessed be his name. Blessed be his name. Blessed be his name. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Do not miss your opportunity. Do not let fear, do not let pride, do not let the fact that you think I'm crazy because I am. I may be listening to the music of the world people are playing, and I'm like this. Do, 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 do. But when it comes to Jesus, I'm like, oh yeah, baby. Uh-huh, uh-huh, uh-huh. Oh yes, oh yes. Hallelujah. Do not miss your opportunity. Church, there is something. You go, oh, I am tired. She's wearing me out. Hey, I'm up here sweating. Do not. We have spent too long, Sandra, sitting on our dairy airs, letting the worship leader and the pastor and everybody else do the work for us. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Hey, we're all guilty. They're up here giving their guts and sweating like a stuck hog is what I say. Have y'all seen the stuck hog sweat? But I'm telling you, it's time for you. I feel that God's people more than ever, this is a political climate. This is a day in which we need God more than we have ever had him before in our lives. And I'm telling you, 1,000 may fall on your left and 10,000 may fall on your right, but it will not come nigh you and your house because your God is the Lord. I'm telling you, things may not be happening right now to you. But I'm telling you right now, let's be proactive rather than reactive. How many of you are tired of the devil getting the best of you and you keep reacting? You just go, oh, coming out of left field. How many of you are ready to do something right now? Today and say, I got you by the tail, honey, and you ain't gonna bully me anymore because I'm gonna do the work. I'm gonna do the work. Today is your day to do the work. Today is your day to shout with a voice of triumph and to take a step of faith. Take a step of faith. We're Pentecostal. You can run. You can jump over these chairs if you want to. But I'm here to tell you, whatever. If your back hurts, I want you to bend down and touch your toes. And if you're not flexible, you can try. If your neck hurts, I want you to move your neck. If you're having heart conditions, I want you to do a little jig. Get that heart rate up. Whatever you got to do. If your knees hurt, I want you to get me some high knees. I want you to do something. Stick your finger in your ear. If Jesus can heal a blind man with spit and mud, I think anything can happen, right? Come on up and I'll spit on you. How about that? Hey, would you let me spit on you if it meant that you get your healing? That's right. That's right. But I want us to sing this song. I want to sing a shout with a voice of triumph. This is a victory cry. A victory cry. Sometimes we have to call those things that are not as though they are. Sometimes, and that's my scripture. I mean, I got a message, y'all. Y'all hang with me, and I want you to move because I feel like we've got the devil on the run, and it's time for him to go. Amen. So let's sing it with all of our hearts.
Shout with a voice of praise. Shout with a voice of triumph.
Boy.
His name, blessed be His name, blessed be His name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Blessed be His name, blessed be His name, blessed be His name. Hallelujah. Holy is the Lord. Holy is the Lord. I want you to high five your neighbor and say, I got me something today. Oh yeah. I want you to sit down for a minute. I'm going to let you sit in the presence of the Lord. How about that? You guys, take a break. Take a rest. Take a minute. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Blessed be His name, blessed be His name, blessed be His name, blessed be His name. Hallelujah. That's it. That's it. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless His holy name. Bless His holy name. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I can't even get y'all to quit. Something is happening, Pastor Beverly. I'm going to let it happen. I'm just going to let it happen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to His name. 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 He is faithful. He gives you favor in the time of your famine. He sets your feet on a solid rock. He plants you. He keeps you. He hems you in. He girds you up. His armor is all around you as you take it. The helmet of salvation, the breastplate of righteousness. Your feet are shod with the shoes of the gospel. And how beautiful are the feet of those who carry the good news. Hallelujah. 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 Blessed be His name. Just lift your right hand one more time and let's just love on Him. Just love Him. Just tell Him you love Him. God, I just love You. I just love You. Hallelujah. We give You honor, God. We give You praise. I feel like somebody's getting strength today for the battle. I feel like that relationships are being restored. I feel like relationships that the enemy has tried to destroy, that God is bringing them back together. That your heart has been breaking, but the God of heaven and earth is coming in with His supernaturally with His gentle hand, and He is bringing healing. And He is healing the other party as well. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Isn't this why we come to church? Isn't this why we come as a body of believers together, so that we might receive corporately? Something very special happens when God's people come together and begin to worship Him in spirit and in truth. Hallelujah. Blessed be His name. Manifestations of miracles. Manifestations of miracles. Manifestation of Your miracle working power, oh God. Hallelujah. 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 Blessed be His name. Blessed be His name. Blessed be His name. Hallelujah. Blessed be His name. 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 We give You honor. Just 15 more seconds, church. 15 more seconds. Just worship Him. Father, we worship You. We give You honor and we give You praise. 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 I feel like that somebody in the house this morning is being healed. I feel like somebody is being healed. I want to see you. I want you to stand up. If God is healing your body in some way, shape, you know God is healing you through this morning. I want you to stand up. Yeah, there we go. Look at that. Look at that. God has healing. God has healed you this morning. He has touched your body. You have felt the warmth and the flowing of His virtue in your body. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise this morning. That's it. I just can't get off of it, Pastor Beverly. I just can't get off of it. And I know we need healing in our bodies. There is so many needs for healing of the body. Nathan's talking about the needs this morning. I want to know who needs healing in their body. Who needs a healing in your body? You need a healing. Keith needs a healing. Stand up if you need a healing. I want you to stand up. Stand up right now. Stand up. Yes. Yes. All right. Now, some of you I know, some of you I don't know what's going on with you. But if you need a healing in your body, I want you just to put your hand over whatever place in your body that you need healing. And I want you right now, I want you to say, I want you in your own way, I receive right now the healing. I speak healing virtue. I speak healing virtue all across this building in the name of Jesus. And God, I speak to every cell, every tissue, every skeletal piece, every bone, every single organ. I speak to it in the name of Jesus. I rebuke the hand of the affliction. I rebuke the hand of infirmity. I rebuke the hand of sickness. And I command it to go now in Jesus' name. And I speak the healing virtue of the Holy Ghost to penetrate those in this building that need your touch, oh God. Lord Jesus. Jesus, I loose your spirit to come in and do all that you've designed them to do in the name of Jesus. And I bind up every hindering spirit, every lying spirit, every spirit of confusion, every spirit of sickness. And I command it to go now in Jesus' name. Somebody give him praise. 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 Hallelujah. 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 Now I want you to move your foot, move your arm. I want you to touch your heart. I want you to move your neck. I want you to touch your toes. Whatever you can do, whatever it is. And I want you to, that's your faith. That's your step of faith that said, God, I believe that I will receive. You know what? Healing is just as easy to receive as salvation. When Jesus died on the cross, he died for our sins and for our healing. He shed his blood so that our souls would be saved. That covers our sins. But his body was broken so that our bodies could be made whole. And it's a finished work. It's a finished work. It's nothing, it's not hocus pocus or magic or little voodoo or whatever. It's not, it's done. It's broken. The curse is broken. The curse of the fall in the Garden of Eden is broken. If by one man the whole world was lost, there's a greater man that came and brought all of the complete work that we need in Jesus' name. Now this morning, believe that you are receiving right now. In Jesus' name, it's done. It's finished. You are healed. You're not gonna be healed. You are healed. It's done. You are under the blood, and you receive all the promise that he has for you. Somebody shout, amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We don't need any mood music to ask God to do what he's already done. We don't have to beg. We don't have to plead. We just have to receive. If by our confession we receive salvation, then I say by confession we receive our healing. God, I believe that you are my healer. It is a finished work. We are made the righteousness of Christ through righteousness of God through Christ Jesus. It's a finished work. I have been justified, saved by grace, and my body is whole because he was wounded for my transgressions. He was bruised for my iniquities. The chastisement of my peace was upon him. And by his stripes I am healed. It's an active work. This is alive. It is not dead. This might as well be a plant right now in a pot. Because it's alive. And it's like a two-edged sword. And it goes forth and it will not return void. In the name of Jesus. So I expect, Pastor Beverly, to hear some things. I'm expecting that you receive, and God's going to do it. Not because I'm up here shouting and being all loud and busting your eardrums out, because I'm getting excited, but because you received and you believed that it's a done deal. It's already been done. Hallelujah. Isn't God good? I don't even have to study the next time I preach because I got a message already. Hallelujah. God will give you favor in the famine. He will give you favor in the famine. When times look bleak, when it looks dry and desolate, when it looks like that your circumstances, there is no way that there can be fruit. There is no way that there can be growth. There is no way that there can be prosperity. You don't even have to get me started on what's going on in our world today. But I want you to know, we belong to the Most High God. And there is nothing, nothing, nothing that He will not do for His kids. That in all things and in every way, in every circumstance, you will abound. That's the word. That's the word. I want you as His church, as believers, I want you to stop hanging your head down low. Or as Sister Doris says, stop wallowing in it. Stop wallowing in it. It rains on the just and the unjust. Good things happen to bad people and bad things happen to good people. It's just because of the fall, right? But see, we don't have to live below what God has decided that we should live. He sent His only Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not have should not perish, but have everlasting life. And Jesus said that He wants us to have life, what? More abundantly. And that's, do you think that's in heaven? Y'all think the abundant life is for heaven? No, because if that's so, take me, Lord Jesus, right now. Bring us all into heaven, right? But He's talking about on earth, because that's the miraculous. This is the earth. This is life. But God wants us to have that life. And He wants us to have favor, provision, prosperity, peace, promotion, protection in this world, in this life, and have it more abundantly. So I want you to walk out these doors today. And I want you to go, yes, life happens. But I want you to say, I am a daughter of the Most High. I am a son of the Most High, and I do not have to live below what He has planned for me, and I'm going to see that in all things, He's going to work it all together for my good, because I love Him, and I am the called according to His purpose. I know He has a plan for me, plans to prosper me and what? Not harm me, plans to give me a hope and a future. So, I'm going to leave you with this word. I'm going to tell you that Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. So when you leave this building today, I want you to trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not unto your own understanding, but in all your ways, acknowledge Him. And He will direct your paths. Or in some, He will make your path what? Straight. How many times do we feel like we're like this? But He says He's going to exalt the valley, bring the mountains down. And He says the angels keep our little pinky toe from hitting against a stone. That's what it says. He says His angels keep your foot from stumbling and from being dashed against a stone. If we who are human beings can give good gifts to our children, how much more? Our Heavenly Father. See, I think, Susanna, we live below. We don't understand how much He loves us. Oh, how He loves us so. Oh, how He loves us. How He loves us so. He is jealous for me. His love's like a hurricane. I am a tree bending beneath the weight of His wind and mercy. Receive that mercy. When all of a sudden I am unaware of these afflictions eclipsed by glory, I realize, thank you, just how beautiful You are and how great Your affections are for me. Sing it. Oh, how He loves us so. Oh, how He loves us. tell him. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because he first loved me. One more time. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Loved me. Hallelujah. Blessed be his name, Pastor Beverly Nathan. Blessed be his name. We just honor you. Thank you, Jesus.
Before Nathan comes to pray over you, I have a word for us as a church. There is just the power of God's presence is just flowing through us. You know, and sometimes we it's easier for us to believe for just the things right in front of us. But I was thinking this morning that God, this is a God of a place of faith. I want to say this exactly right because I believe God has something for us to understand. We have a faith that's going through here. And I believe in that God desires to prosper us. Through jobs, through wisdom. He says he gives us power to get wealth. And I believe that, you know, sometimes our economy in the natural, Texas has been blessed. Our economy really hasn't been hit. But in the world right now, there's a stirring of this is uncomfortable. This is happening. This is, you know, people are looking for new jobs. People are looking for a second job. But God wants to give you the wisdom to move in faith and in prosperity. And I believe that we can have what we believe for, and I believe that God wants to bless. He says he gives us power to get wealth. He said, if any man lacks wisdom, let him ask of God, who gives wisdom to all things. And I believe that he wants to give us the wisdom. He wants to give us the wisdom to financially support our family, to financially take care of our children, to take care of our parents. God is moving financially, and I believe that we have an environment right now to believe God to minister to these are financial needs, these are physical needs and tangible needs, and sometimes we think they're not as important to God, but they are. Whatever we care about, God cares about. And I believe that he can give us favor. You know, we can walk in favor in the world. You know, we can walk into a place and ask for a job, and they might baptize everybody else, but that person is a person of favor. They have God's favor on their lives. And I believe in the power of favor. And God wants us to trust him for every single thing. So as a body, and I believe that as a body of Christ and as a body at Life Fellowship Church, that we can come together and pray a covering over this body of Christ, and he can bring prosperity, meet every financial need, that we won't struggle here and there and everywhere, but we walk in faith in what God has us to do. You know, about 5 years ago, I'm not good at dates, but before our economy and people were starting to lose jobs, the Lord had played on my heart about businesses. And this is one of those moments, and right after I started praying about businesses, it was when later just it's like the world went crazy and the economy and the market went down, everything happened. But I believe God speaks to us ahead of time, and I believe this is one of those moments. He's speaking to us ahead of time to prepare us, to prepare our mind, prepare our faith to seek and to hold on to what he has for us. And I want us to grab a hold of that. Sandra, I was just, as we were praying today, I pray prosperity over you. Toby, I was looking for you. We were all praying. I was looking, where's Toby? Where's Toby? Where's Toby? I pray prosperity over you. Prosperity. And if he means it for one, he means it for all of us. We can all grasp it. So I want us to pray together right now and pray over this body and believe for that prosperity to be ours. Lord, in the name of Jesus, I thank you that you are faithful. You're faithful in everything that you've called us to. You've faithful to meeting our physical needs, our financial needs, our health. Lord, in the name of Jesus, right now we approach your throne, Father. We come boldly before the throne of grace to ask for help in the time of need. And Lord, I speak over this body of Christ at Life Fellowship Church. I speak financial blessings. Lord, you said you give us the power to get wealth. You said we can ask for wisdom, that you will give us wisdom. You will give us wisdom for ideas to prosper our business, to advance us in our jobs. Lord, and right now I just ask for financial prosperity to sweep across this congregation. Lord, those that are here, the members that are not here, in the name of Jesus, I speak financial prosperity. We break the curse of poverty, that it does not exist upon us in the name of Jesus. But Lord, I pray that the financial blessings will flow through this congregation. And Lord, we will be faithful to give unto your name. We will be faithful to advance the kingdom of God. We will be faithful to reach out to others, Lord, and influence the kingdom of God with the prosperity that you have given us, Lord God. And right now, we just receive financial blessings upon our life. Lord, upon our families, Lord, we shall not lack, but we will overflow these coming years. We will overflow in what you desire to give us, Father. We will not lack because we stand on the authority of your word. And your word is faithful. Your word, you desire to meet every need in our lives, Father. And I thank you for it. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen. Amen. We're going to receive testimony of what God has done. Mr. Nathan, will you come and just pray over us tonight?
Renee, thank you for obeying the Spirit. And when she was talking about relationships, some of you have some people who aren't in this building that you're affected with relationships with them. I saw dispatches of angels, and I know things were shifted in the heavenlies for those relationships. So have faith today that God already, he was working here this morning, but he was working elsewhere too, already shifted, already taking care of those things. Amen. Believe him this morning. Let us pray. Father, we thank you so much for your blessings this morning. We thank you for your presence, Father. We don't take it for granted. And we just thank you that you ministered to people in this congregation that came in one way, but now they're going to leave a different way because of the power of God, the power of the blood, the power of the Spirit of God, your presence. And Father, we just thank you for it. I ask you to bless each one as we go our separate ways throughout this week. Keep your hand upon us. Protect us. Supply every need according to your riches and glory through Jesus Christ. And we give you the glory, we give you the honor, and we give you all the praise in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. God bless you. Oh, Miss Sandra, go ahead. One moment, please.
I don't think I really need the microphone, but everybody has been prayed over today, whether it was healing or prosperity or whatever your need was. And the Lord just says, walk it out. If you feel like, oh, I may not have received that, I don't know whether I did or not, walk it out. And I'm literally meaning walk it out. Yes. And praise him, yes, every step for whatever it is. Yes. Thank you that my leg is healed. Even though it doesn't feel like it's healed right now, I know you've healed it, Lord. I know I'm prosperous. Yes. I know I have wisdom. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Yes. Because you've already had that prayer prayed over you today. So once that's done, praise him, praise him, praise him. And you will be amazed at the results. You'll just be walking along one day and you'll think, oh my gosh, I don't have that anymore. Because you praised him for the results, yes, and that's using your faith. Praise God.
Amen. Thank you, Sister Sandra. Hallelujah. God bless each one of you. Have a wonderful week in the Lord. Amen.